Disease diagnosis is an important component of fish health management. In this video, we are going to learn about various steps of disease diagnosis process, starting from sample handling, external examination, and pathogen identification to antibiotic susceptibility testing for an important fish pathogen, Aeromonas hydrophila. Preparation of bacterial culture media. Media preparation is a basic step in any microbiology and disease diagnosis lab. For media preparation, follow the required steps carefully. Weigh the required quantity of culture media and dissolve in distilled water. Add the cotton plugs. Label the media properly. For liquid broth media, distribute the required quantities in test tubes. Sterilize the media by autoclaving. Generally, autoclaving is performed at 121 degrees Celsius for 15 minutes. For agar media, allow it to cool down to 45 to 50 degrees Celsius and then pour into sterile Petri plates. These plates can be stored at 4 degrees Celsius till further use. Fish sample handling, external examination and presumptive isolation of Aeromonas hydrophila. Proper sample collection and transportation is very much crucial for successful disease diagnosis. Only the moribund fishes showing apparent disease symptoms should be used for diagnosis. The samples need to be transported to lab under properly packed and iced conditions. Once in the lab, fish should be examined for external symptoms such as hemorrhage, lesions, wounds, tails and fin rot, visible parasites, etc. For bacterial enrichment, take the external swab from affected areas. Also, collect the internal kidney organ and inoculate in tryptone soy broth. Incubate overnight at 35 to 37 degrees Celsius. Check the tubes for bacterial growth. treat the overnight growth bacterial culture on Rimmler Schatz agar for isolation of Aeromonas hydrophila. Incubate the streaked plate overnight at 35 to 37 degrees Celsius. Check the plates for typical yellow color colonies. Pick these colonies and inoculate in tryptoned soy broth. Incubate overnight at 35 to 37 degrees Celsius for bacterial growth. Confirmatory identification of Aeromonas hydrophila by polymerase chain reaction, that is PCR. For confirmatory identification, PCR is one of the rapid and convenient methods in diagnostic laboratory. Take out the required PCR reagents, except TAC polymerase, from the deep freezer. Calculate the master mix requirements. Thaw the PCR reagents, vortex and spin briefly. Prepare the PCR master mix by adding required components. Aliquot the master mix into individual PCR tubes. add the bacterial DNA samples. Also, use the positive and negative controls. Keep the tubes in PCR thermal cycler. Design and run the required PCR program. Add the required quantity of agarose powder in 1x tris acetate EDTA buffer. Boil to dissolve the agarose. Allow it to cool to 45 to 50 degrees Celsius and add required quantity of ethidium bromide. Shake gently to mix. Pour into casting tray with comb and allow it to solidify. Remove the comb and transfer the gel to electrophoresis tank. Load 5 to 10 microliter of PCR sample in each well after mixing with 6x loading dye. Also load 100 base pair DNA ladder. Start the electrophoresis at 100 to 120 volts. After electrophoresis, visualize the gel in UV transilluminator. See the positive control, sample, negative control, and ladder bands to determine the PCR results. Save the result image. antibiotic susceptibility testing of Aeromonas hydrophila. Susceptibility of Aeromonas hydrophila to various antibiotics is tested by disc diffusion method. Young log phase bacterial culture with cell counts of 10^8 CFU per ml is needed for AST. Prepare the bacterial lawn on Muller-Hinton agar plate and allow it to dry for 5 to 10 minutes. Place 4 to 5 numbers of antibiotics discs on each lawn with gentle pressing. Incubate at 35 to 37 degrees Celsius for 16 to 18 hours. After incubation, measure the diameters of zones of inhibition for each antibiotic. Compare the inhibition zones against clinical and laboratory standards institute criteria to make the resistant, sensitive, intermediate calls.